So it's 5:30 in the morning and now we are heading towards Dombivli station. So YOLO guys, today we are going for a trek at Mahuli Fort. As you can see, we are at Dombivli station and it's around 6 in the morning. So let's see how our trek goes. So guys, we have finally reached Asangaon station and these are my friends. They are going to accompany me for this trek. So this is Lokesh, Biradar, and this is Sandy. Ye abhi so ke aaya hai, as you can see.
So guys,
bichara ye office se hai. He has come all the way from his office. He had a night shift and from there he has come over here. You can show your face.
Yeah, just for you, buddy.
So on the left of the Asangaon station, there is a rickshaw stand over here. But they are charging almost 250 rupees for a ride from Asangaon to Mahuli. So that's not economical. So we have asked a local and he told me that we will get a bus from Shahpur. We are going back from there. We will be going to Shahpur and then we will be Mahuli. So we have taken a rickshaw Asangaon station to Shahpur. So this is the Shahpur bus stop. Season Gawa. So that's the place. So guys, finally we have reached the base of Mahuli and over there that's the Mahuli fort. It's covered by clouds so we can't see it, but yes, we are heading over there.
CD सोडून गेले ना की CD लागले की तो पालसगड राईट मारून पालसगड लागले.
ओके,
त्या बाजूनी लेफ्ट साइड ने भंडारगड आहे,
बाजूने
माहुली.
And there's a shop over here at the base of the Mahuli fort. That last shop we have taken some water bottles because there is no other shop or anything in between while we are trekking. So we have started our trek. That's the entrance gate over there, the ticket counter over there. So guys, we have started our Mahuli trek. This Mahuli fort is in Tansa Wildlife Sanctuary in the Thane district. Mahuli fort is also the highest peak of Thane district. Its height is around 2815 feet, which makes it around 850 meters roughly.
Thank you.
So there's a deer over there. So guys, we actually saw a deer over here. So guys, that's the village we have started from, and now we have covered this much distance and we are on the first bridge. So from the first bridge we can get an awesome view of the surrounding area. Now we can hear sounds of a variety of birds. We are trying to spot them, but let's see. I am doing a trek after so many days. The last trek I did was in January. So I am a bit tired, but take a look at my friends. It is his first trek and the person behind is quite dead. Chal, you can do it.
You have gym man, gym boy.
Thoda sa. So as you can see, there are some railings built on the way towards the fort. So it's quite humid over here. We were expecting rain, but there's no rain. So guys, we have actually completed 60% till now. And from here, the flag over there, if you can see it, okay, yeah. So that flag is the Mahuli Fort and we are heading towards there. But my friends are a bit tired. You can see Sandy sitting over there and he is dead. He's signaling that he is dead. And Lokesh, can you continue? We are taking quite few hauls in between, so we will be a bit late to reach the top, but we are trying to be there as soon as possible. Just hope my friend gets energized again. We have given him some electrol and stuff. Let's see. It's been almost 1.5 hours and we are still on this track. So after a long halt of almost around 20 minutes, my friend has recovered and we have again proceeding towards the trek to Mahul Fort. This is the view of the magnificent Sahyadri ranges. So this is the view of the Mahuli colony. It's the Palasgad over there. This is the Mahuli Fort and that's the Bhandargad. You can see a flag over here. So this is the guy who was tired and he's so much ahead of us. We'll be right back. some locals over here. They had stayed all night over there and they are now descending. Road is quite narrow and let's see if we can go over there. As you can see my two fingers, the road is only this much and I will try to go. I am standing over here, as you can see how deep the valley is, and there goes the valley all the way down there. And according to me, the best part of this trek, being it sun shining above me, the best part of the track according to me is the winds. And above that, the scenic beauty that the Sahyadri ranges offers is actually unbeatable. So few moments early I was standing over there. The guy who was tired is now energized again. Oh! So the dancer of our group has started doing his job. He's actually dancing on the route of the trek of Mahuli Fort. Yeah! Yeah, so finally Mahuli Fort. Here you can see some arrows for assistance of the trekkers. And so this is a small pond which was the source of water at this fort when this fort was actually standing tall and not in the ruins as it is now. So now we are heading towards the Mahuli caves. So this route goes to the Bhandargad and the small lake over there and the Shiv Mandir over there. But as of now, we will be first going to the caves, and after lunch, we will be going at Bhandargad to explore it. So we are now going towards the caves. It's quite cool over here. So that's the caves over there. Here, there's a sculpture and this is the only fresh water source on this fort, and the water is quite actually drinkable, but you need to filter it to just be on a safer side. But you can drink this water and it is the only source of water. And if you are planning a trek to Mahuli, try carrying more water because you will literally feel thirsty and you need water to drink. But by chance, if your water is over, you can fill it over here. So as you can see, there is a shivling over here. Some sculptures scripted on it. According to me, these sculptures or these rocks are from the 16th century when Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj had captured this fort. Here's a small and a beautiful statue of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. So guys, now we are standing at the Pravesh Dwar or the entrance gate of the Mahuli Fort. As you can see now, it is actually in ruins, but that's a great history of Mahuli Fort. It was built in the year around 14th century. And this was built as a single piece of rock carved in a mountain. And then the additional bricks or the pieces of rock were added later to give it a curved surface like this, as you can see over there. So it's actually a marvelous piece of architecture. Over here, we can also see the ruins of the Pravesh Dwar, which the carvings of the Dwar are over here. This, I believe this was actually a part of the arch of the Pravesh Dwar, the arch which is now in 16th century. The Britishers had actually blasted the entrance route and parts of Mahuli Fort to make it unusable. So before that, it was standing strong and still. It has more bigger history, and we will talk about it soon. Here you can see some carvings of flowers and some animal carvings over here. I believe these were also the part of the Pravesh Dwar and the arch of the Pravesh Dwar. As we enter the Pravesh Dwar, there are few caves which I believe at that time was the home or place of stay of the Pehredars, the watchman we called in modern time. So this cave over here is actually calm and cool, and you can actually use it for a stay over here. If you enter the cave, it is a clean place, planned a one-day trek, or you can stay overnight over here. So this is a great place. So as you can see, the Namaz Ghar. Actually, Mahuli Fort was built by Mughals and maintained by Mughals in around 14th century. After that, it came under the Nizam Shahi. At that time, Shahaji Raji, the father of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, was the secretary of Nizam Shahi. It is said that Mughals tried to end Nizam Shahi. So in order to prevent Nizam Shahi from being ended, Shahaji Raji brought the last inheritance of Nizam Shahi along with Jijamata and Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj to this Mahuli Fort. And from here, he tried to protect the Nizam Shahi. In the period of war, due to some circumstances, Shahaji Raji was unable to protect the fort. He thus asked Portuguese for their help. But Portuguese refused to help because they feared the Mughals, and at the end, Shahaji Raji had to surrender. And this was all done in 16th century. Some years later, in 16th century, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj attacked Mahuli Fort and conquered it. But some years later, in the 16th century, he had to surrender the Mahuli Fort in the Treaty of Purandari. The Treaty of Purandari was actually a very significant and strategic event in the Maratha Empire. So we will talk about it when we will reach the Bhandar. So now we are going at Bhandargad Fort. So stay tuned. So this is not the actual authorized route, we have taken another route. So as you can see, there's a ladder over here and there's a stairs. So that's the Bhandargad Fort, and we are going there. So there's a ladder over here, but there is no support. So we have came all the way from that village through the Mahuli Fort and through the road to here. And this is the Bhandargad Fort. We are still reaching over there. So as you can see, there are so many pinnacles over here. And it is not possible to reach the top of the or climb the pinnacle without rope or rappelling. That is why it is the Mahuli area is also the paradise of rock climbing, because you need to know rock climbing and you need to do rock climbing to reach the top of each or every pinnacle. And that's the beauty of this place. So that's the Asangaon station and industrial area over there. That's the THANE station, and further that side, that's the Mumbai area. We can't see that area because it's quite cloudy over there, but that's the Mumbai area. So now we are at Bhandargad. Bhandargad and Palasgad are actually sub-fort or vice forts of Mahuli. In Marathi, it is known as Upadhi.
Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj has used the Mahuli Fort very strategically in the Treaty of Purandare that we were talking earlier. So in the Treaty of Purandare, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj had to surrender 23 forts to the Mughals. And at that time, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj convinced the Mughals that Mahuli Fort was actually not one but three forts. That is Mahuli Fort, Bhandargad Fort and Pallasgad. And this way, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj only saved two forts of the Swarajya.
So as you can see, we have finally reached Kalyan Darwaza. And we are going towards that. So this is the Kalyan Darwaza, and this was another strategic location because this was acting as a watchtower between the Kalyan and the Western Ghats. So this is the Kalyan Darwaza area, and this is actually the Kalyan Darwaza arc, and we are in between. Rikshaw near the Manas Mandir shop, and finally we are just chilling